Good morning, students. Welcome in your online classes. And today I am going to explain you suspension and collides. Last day I was already explained that what is true solution and what are their properties. Now today I am going to explain you suspension and collides. Suspension. A suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. Yes, last day I was already explained what are heterogeneous and what are homogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures are those mixtures in which the composition is equal throughout the whole mixture. As in the another hand, heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture are those mixtures in which the composition throughout the whole mixture is not equal. So that is the difference. So suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. So it is clear that in suspension the composition of solute and solvent are not equal through the whole mixture. Homogeneous mixture in which the small particles of a solid are spread throughout a liquid without dissolving in it. Yes. The main difference between a solution and a suspension, that is the particle of solution is completely dissolved between the solute, and in suspension the particle of solvent is not completely dissolved or not dissolved in the solute. Means the main difference is solute is dissolved, solute is not dissolved. The size of the particles of solute is very much bigger than the two solutions. Means the particles are very big, so they are not adjustable between the two molecules. So if we are making aqueous solution, then the particle of suspensions are not able to adjust or to stick or to take space between the two particles of water. But in solution, the particle of solution, the particle of solution are able to stick or to stay between the two molecules of water. That's why they are completely dissolved and they are equal composition throughout the solution. For example, chalk water mixture. Yes, chalk water mixture or sand water mixture, these are the examples of suspension. Means the particles are not dissolved. Chalk powder is not dissolved in water. After stirring, they not dissolve in water. After we leave that type of mixture with a few minutes or after few hours, you realize that the particles of chalk are settled down slowly in the bottom of the glass. Whatever you have taken, the tumbler or whatever glass, the particles of chalk is settled down in the bottom. Now collide. Collide is a middle thing. Means it comes between solution and suspension. It comes between solution and suspension. It is a middle thing. The part and the size of the particles and the size of the collides is also comes between the size of the particles of true solution or suspension. Means size are also comes between the size of the true solution or the size of the suspension. The definition is collides. A collide is a kind of solution in which the size of solute particles is intermediate between those in true solution and those in suspension. Yes, I was told you the size of the particles is intermediate. Means comes between the size of the true solution or the size of the suspension. Next, an example is milk and egg. Yes, these are the example of collide. A very important example I want to tell you, that how we differentiate that the true solution is a true solution and a collide is a collide. One example is very common, that a paint. Paint is a kind of collide. You realize that when a person is start painting, he is always suggested that mix well, because the particles are settled down after few days or after few years. Particles are settled down, so the concentration of the particle is not equal throughout the whole of the mixture. So that's why the painter before painting the paint. So the particles mix again and then we are painting. It means the particles is also chiseled down with for a long time. Now concentration of solution. Yes, how we find out how much amount of solute dissolve in solution? How much amount of solute it dissolve in solution? So this is the way to find out how much the solute is dissolved in solution and how much percentage it is. So it is concentration of solution. Concentration of solution is defined as the mass of solute in gram present in 100 gram of solution. Yes, if we have 100 gram of solution, so if we know that what is the amount of solute present in that 100 gram of solute, so that concentration is that value is called the concentration of solution. And this is the formula: concentration of solution equals to mass of solute, whatever we have taken the solute mass in gram, and mass of solution, the whole solution mass, into 100. Then we find out the percentage or the amount which is present in the solution. Thank you. Have a nice day.